So you anticipated some of the potential advantage, and also John did some a review of the potential outcomes of the robotic hepatectomy. So I think I will probably go faster in the first part of the presentation, focusing on some of the technical advantages of the robotic approach. This is my disclosure. So in fact, there is one clear point. The penetration of minimal invasive surgery in the field of liver resection is growing. It's growing because there is more awareness and the scientific demonstration that we can achieve better outcomes for our patients, and also the patient might enjoy not only better oncological outcomes, but the benefits of minimal invasive approaches. Look at what happened with the pediatric living donor. It's becoming more and more, let's say, minimal invasive matter. So probably the same would happen for all other kinds of liver resection. So I'm not going to bother you. Everybody knows that there are limitations on laparoscopy. Only few extraordinary surgeons, exceptionally talented. We have seen this morning for the Whipple, Dr. Kendrick, and Dr. Coffron is another excellent, talented or super talented minimal invasive surgeon. But majority, we have to be honest, majority of surgeons, they may have difficulty in struggling with some of the mechanical limitations of laparoscopy. So in particular, speaking about liver, say bleeding control, and I would like to remind that, yes, we might have energies, but John, you are sealing the major right hepatic vein with the Wester sealer. I don't know, probably you are lucky, because I've seen many examples of reopening of the right hepatic vein after. So I don't know, are you suturing after that? Okay, so there is a mixing of, and say for the average surgeon, and probably I'm belonging to that kind of category, I think stapling the right hepatic vein is a good advice. Same, stay intracapsular, and the last few steps of the transection, parenchyma transection, are safely and very fast done with the stapling. So I wouldn't be comfortable in advising younger surgeons in a different way and say stapler is too much expensive, you have not to use them. So remember that staple might help you in getting out faster and effectively in some difficult intraparenchymal situation of the liver. Biliary anastomosis, of course, when we are dealing with very advanced resection, including resection of the bile duct and reconstruction, intrahepatic reconstruction, you might deal with small, very thin walls of the ducts, and or they might be distant. If you're doing an extended left and you have to make a reconstruction of the anterior and posterior, and you have two ducts, one here, and to do an anastomosis, a microsurgical technique laparoscopically, that might be challenging. Posterior segment question marks. I don't know if the robot is the right answer to that. There are exceptional laparoscopies like Professor Gaillet in Paris that is using some combined intrathoracic or thoracoabdominal approaches for that. Not sure if the robot might really help for that kind of difficult segments. And there are advanced lesions, vascular involvement, and obese patient. And the combination of difficult anatomy like an obese or super obese patient plus a small deep chest. When you have a kind of hourglass conformation, so you have your port sites that are on top of the abdomen, even though they are close to the costal margin, and plus you have your small chest very deep into, it becomes very challenging laparoscopically to do a resection in that condition. And I think obesity is another reason why probably the robot is more advantageous. We have better length of the better control of the instruments. So again, I want to spend the time on the literature. We Dr. Martini already explained some of these. Let's focus on some of the clear advantages. Alan already mentioned that the dissection in the ilum may be very precise. And honestly, the robotic platform is a combination of multiple different features that are making the robotic platform like a microscope that is reaching the ilum of the liver and in a very comfortable way with the maximal exposure that you can achieve. Some trick might be splitting, pre-splitting the anterior aspect of the liver and then using the third arm to open up in a fish mouth action. You can enter into the ilum and still you have your microsurgical ability. So I'm expecting, for example, in biliary cancer like Klatskin, that was considered one limitation of laparoscopy, probably another possible advantage. So better suturing, and I reminded that even suturing for hemostatic reason is one of the cheapest and most effective way to control the situation. We shouldn't forget our original art that was basically based on ability of suturing, and with the robot I think we are back to that suturing, not only to create a new anastomosis but also to control perfectly a bleeding. We can skip some of these I have a lot of clips that you can review some example of I always remember that the hook is the best instrument for the ilum because it's a combination of a right angle, and you can use the tip for sharp dissection and the back for coagulation. And a combination also with new modalities of imaging like the fluorescence, it can make the identification of the anatomy of the bifurcation. You know, here a surgeon has to know perfectly all the variants that they might happen. You have trifurcation, aberrant ducts. There are a lot of variations, and sometimes the extrahepatic dissection might become challenging or risky for fistula by leak. Increasing the ability of recognizing the anatomy, I think, is a way to improve the dissection. It's a very nice clip, but we should move forward. Another advantage that has not been mentioned, and that is a part of major, and they agree that major resection are just probably a part of the overall volume of a resection, in between 10-20% of the resection, but still they are a good important model, and in some situations you have to do. The preparation of the vena cava, I think, is another advantage because really you can work in a very parallel way with your instrumentation. So you can do the hanging maneuver that, or the modified hanging maneuver that in many situations I prefer. So it means that unless there is a lesion that is in contact or infiltrating the vena cava, instead of preparing the tunnel just in front of the vena cava, you can do that immediately on the right side of the vena cava. So this is a modification of the hanging maneuver. It's equally effective because you are lifting up the right lobe of the liver out of the cava, and then if you have problems at the end of the resection with the right hepatic vein, the direction of the instruments is guided by the lifting of the lobe. So you can be very precise, and you can prepare the entire vena cava and deconnect the entire right lobe, or if it's difficult, they have too many collaterals, you can prepare a modified hanging maneuver on the right side of the vena cava. This is work is extremely precise and can be done better than laparoscopy just because vision and combination of different action of the tools, you can work in a parallel way to the vena cava. Biliary reconstruction, I want to spend time. This is an example of an extended left where two ducts have been put together and then with a microsurgical technique and then you can make a better anastomosis with interrupted 6-0 suturing that is PDS, monofilament for this kind of suturing. I called it, this is another very nice application, I skipped that. Bleeding control, some example, this is probably, you can put clips as well or stapling, but is some example of suturing that you can do. Probably the anesthesia was keeping to a higher pressure here, but a few cc of blood and then you can really with nice rounded movements of your needle, you can suture perfectly and you can get out of any situation. ICG, probably localization, will make a lot of improvement in localizing lesions inside the liver. Example of using ICG for hepatocellular carcinoma, that's colorant is uptaken by the tumor immediately and by the liver, but the tumor is unable to metabolize the color, and so in few seconds the color disappear out of the tumor, and you will see this is a real-time image and is becoming gray simply because there is no metabolic action of the cancer cells. And I think based on this kind of vascular partner, we would be able to develop digital pathology, and in a few years it will be incorporated in the platform. So you will be able to work and simultaneously you may have an idea of the pathology that you are working with, and potentially this kind of implementation would decrease the errors in the margins that I reminded that in many situations, including the resection for liver mets, to have a good margin is still the one most significant parameters in prevention of recurrence. I'm skipping some of those because we are late. A parenchyma transection, I think there are different techniques. I don't want to enter into this because other surgeons are more experienced. Still, I think that the harmonic, if it's properly used, is a wonderful instrument. But I can guarantee I've been training tens and tens of surgeons in that it's difficult to find people using well the instrument. And there are basic concepts that need to be known. The instrument has to meet the anatomy of the vessels at least with a 90 degrees angle, because otherwise it's ineffective. Simply you get more bleeding. You're pushing the instrument more inside and you get more bleeding. The direction of the instrument has to be moved. It has to be exactly aligned and parallel to the line of dissection. And you need to get marsupialization of the dissection line. So you have to have exposure of your dissection line. And you can go through the, I've seen Dr. Che from Korea in the last meeting doing a marvelous left hepatectomy done with the harmonic, and there was no bleeding at all. And there was a perfect anatomical dissection. I'm sure that he will show some other example of that. So even the harmonic is a wonderful instrument, but need to be learned. And this stability of the platform, because there is no variation in tension, because the robotic platform is able to decrease, cut the tremors, so there is a uniformity of delivery of the energy. So paradoxically, the robotic harmonic is working much better on the liver than the laparoscopic harmonic. But I don't want to open this. I really am convinced that there is a field of growth, technological growth. We, for sure, we can do better in the Heirloom, we can do better on the Vina Cava. We need better dedicated tools for the party. I'm not convinced that the Vessel Sealess is the right tool. It's a little too large. And it has a kind of crushing effect when closing the jaws that is difficult to control. So dedicated tools for liver parenchyma and or other devices. I think probably the future here is connected with the further specialized development of the tools. But I see clearly a future of the robotic platform. I would like to mention and conclude with that the hybrid application. Of course, we are concerned about costs, but there are difficult fields of liver surgery, including transplants or a situation where you need a microscopic platform for reconstruction. I think the robot is the best microscopic platform that you can bring in. We had with Dr. Benedetti a few examples of cooperation for difficult transplant. For example, a delayed biliary reconstruction after a difficult split transplant with a lot of oozing has been closed, stabilized the patient, and the following day the patient has been brought back to the OR for the biliary reconstruction. And in that difficult field, I think the robotic platform, even in open wound, is able to perform extremely well. So now we are dealing with cost. Probably one day the robot will be a normal equipment of the OR, and we will be feel comfortable in bringing the robot in when it is required. So even exploring the indication of hybrid approaches, minimizing the open accesses and taking the advantage of the best of the open and the best of the minimal invasive. I know that it is a little bit provocative, this at this stage, but I see definitely a future of that. Briefly, our experience, if you're looking at conversion rate, mortality zero, morbidity, fistula rate, biliary fistula, I think results are excellent. And so as a demonstration that a good learning and good application of the basic principles of liver surgery, even in the robotic platform, we can achieve excellent results, and probably the future will be better and better. I will stop here. Thank you.